Looking to improve your life, brush up on your personal growth techniques? You are in the right place. Welcome to Life's Little Lessons with your host, author of Designing Your Own Destiny, Kevin A. Dunlap.
Hello, everybody. This is Kevin Dunlap with Life's Little Lessons. And today I have another absolutely amazing woman. We've been having a couple of conversations before this actual interview, and I'm so happy to be bringing her to our show. Her name is Sue Richards, and she's actually from Birmingham, the UK, not Birmingham, Alabama. So she is across the pond, the big pond, I think is what they call it. And if you like this show, I would say go ahead and leave a comment below. Go ahead and subscribe to our channel, because as you know, we're bringing a lot of different kind of guests from all over the world to the show, and you would want to get these updates as they're coming alive to you. Anyway, back to Sue Richards. Sue Richards is a coach back in the UK. She's been in business for quite some time. We're going to go into more detail about what she's doing. So without any further ado, let's welcome Sue Richards to the show. Sue, welcome to our show.
Thank you, Kevin. Thank you so much. I'm so excited to be here, actually. I always love talking about what I do. So any opportunity to share knowledge and share content is always good by me.
Oh, fantastic. And so could you tell us a little bit about yourself? What did you do? How long have you been doing it and stuff
like that? Yeah, of course. So I'm a self-professed, I suppose, but I call myself a sales success coach. So I work with entrepreneurs, coaches, consultants, anybody really with a service-driven business that is looking to build a business. Doesn't have to be online, although I do tend to be working a lot more with people across the globe, which is fantastic, which is why you and I have connected as well, because I'm networking more further afield. But my background, really, to kind of take you right back, is, you know, 18 years now. Now we're in 2018. 18 years in the sales industry. Really starting off in the staffing industry for a good 11 years, and building my way up in the corporate world. So I've done the phone bashing, you know, telesales. I've been out on the road. I've managed sales teams. I've directed sales teams. And I've also been the VP of sales across the whole of the UK for a leading marketing agency. But then a good 6 years ago is when I really went into entrepreneurship myself. Over in the UK, we call it redundancy. I think you guys call it laid off, or I don't know how you word it, but I was made redundant about 6 years ago. And I can tell you it was the best thing that ever happened to me, because it gave me the opportunity to just do what I want to do and build a business. I'd worked with small businesses for the 6 previous years in the marketing agencies. And I really admired small business owners building businesses and growing businesses and just really going with their passion. I mean, the industry I was in, I was talking to plumbers, I was talking to car mechanics, beauticians, but these were all small local businesses, and I was becoming envious of their ability to do something for themselves. So when I got made redundant, because I have a family and, you know, not everybody wants to take the leap, gave me the opportunity to build my own business. And having at that point, having a good 15 or, you know, so years in sales, or 11 years, I think it was at the time, in sales and being a director and being a VP of sales, it was obvious that that was my go-to. And I started a business, SDR Business Solutions, which was a sales training business. And I trained sales teams. I went into businesses and trained their sales teams. So I would look at sales processes and I'd look at their teams. I'd teach people that are out on the road, and any kind of sales process that I, you know, had experience with, all very much service-based. That's my expertise. I'm not necessarily the best person to come to if you want to sell a pen. But if you want to sell a service and you want to sell value in what you do, that's what I do. I think most people, most entrepreneurs, realize that you hit a ceiling, right? You hit a ceiling in your earning potential when you're just trading your time for money. Mm. Which is what I was doing. I had a training business. I had no desire to build the business and hire a team and build it that way. So the online world started to become more and more attractive. I started thinking about how can I leverage my knowledge and my experience and create something that can serve the masses. And through doing research, I realized that online coaching and putting some courses together and being able to really reach out to those people that are starting out and spread knowledge. So that's what I did back in 2016. So it's about 2 years ago. I kind of switched my focus from B2B, as we call it, a corporate world, to the individual entrepreneurs. Because I tell you the one thing, when you go into a corporate company to train a sales team, they don't want you there. The directors of the business want you there. The managers of the business want you there. But the people sat in the room, they don't want you there. They haven't invested in you. They're not necessarily going to implement what you've said. But when I'm sat down with an entrepreneur who is, you know, sales is their business, they know that if they don't get the sales part of their business right, they don't have a business. And that for me was a completely different experience. People that were hanging off every word because they truly wanted to get better. They were so invested, so coachable, so resourceful, and they were massive action takers that the results were instant. And that was when I realized this is where I want to be. And so 2 years down the line, I now have I've gone through different iterations. So I've worked with a 7-figure coach and been her sole coach, sales coach for her clients. And that was amazing. I had a lot of experience doing that. I learned about the industry, but now I'm putting my own courses and doing my own one-on-one programs. So that's where I am now, is really building and working with entrepreneurs to just absolutely smash those sales myths and really understand that sales is actually not about selling, it's about serving.
Exactly. Because I remember I saw this one post on Facebook, and it says, what do you think about when you hear the word sales? And,
yes.
And I know a comment that I replied to that is, well, sales is selling something that somebody needs and where somebody else is paying for, because that is what they want. So that takes the negative connotation out of sales, because if you have a service or product that you can provide that is of value and other people are willing to pay for it, then it's not like, you know, you're not being that sleazy car salesman. It's you being genuine and being authentic.
Exactly. I think with all my years experience, and I've had a lot of training, I've been sent on very expensive training courses, and I've learned ways myself, and I've mentored other people. And some of those kind of old tactics, I'm going to call them, the old way of selling, which was very much about go out and present. Go out and tell the world about your product or service. Tell them why you're better than anybody else. I remember when I was trained with a recruitment agency and we had our sales pitch, which was a sales deck, a PowerPoint presentation. And the first 3 or 4 slides was all about the company, how long we've been going in business, all of the other companies that we've worked with, how amazing we were. And we were genuinely pitching from the second we walked into a room, the second we were sat down, you were taught to pitch. Because years ago, that was the only way you could get your message out there. We didn't have the internet. We didn't have, yes, we had television and radio, but it wasn't two-way. So the only way somebody could really be educated about your product or service was to be pitched to. Well, you know, you fast forward where we are now, 9 times out of 10, if I walk into a conversation with a potential client, they probably know more about me and my competitors than I do. So, especially the competitors. So it's not about me. It's not about you. It's about your potential client. And that's the first mindset shift that my clients have to go through. Because you're absolutely right. I think one of the first sentences, I think I saw the same post as you. I think we're in the same group. And I saw things like, oh no, and sleazy and pushy and salesy and, you know, selling things that I don't want. And we need to get away from that, because if we feel like that about sales, then we're going to take that energy and think that everybody sees us like that. Well, so we have to get rid of that.
And that's kind of the funny thing is, because this was in an entrepreneurs group.
Yeah.
I mean, so if you're dealing with entrepreneurs, it doesn't matter if you're selling hamburgers, a online course, or how to speak French. I mean, you're still, whatever your business is, you're still, for you to be alive, you have to make sales.
Exactly. The process between somebody not being a customer and somebody becoming a customer or a client, that's called a sale. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if you've come across so many people, they are that nervous, probably is the word, or fearful of the word sales or the sales process, is that they tell me, I don't do sales. I don't have to sell in my business. So
how do they pay the bills?
But then when you have that conversation, you have, well, I get referrals. Well, just because, don't you think a marketing exercise, don't you think a webinar or an advert is still a referral? You've still got to have a conversation with that referral that's then going to turn into a client.
Yeah, lead to your client conversion. Because even if it's a referral, it's still just a lead.
Yeah, exactly. The great thing is with referrals is they're probably the hottest leads you're ever going to get if they've been referred correctly to you. Mm-hmm. But my question is if you're only relying on referrals, how many other people are you missing out on that need your services? Mm-hmm. That if they don't come to you with their credit card in their hand saying, where do I sign? That doesn't mean that there are other people that don't need your services and aren't willing to work with you. So you're leaving money on the table by not having sales conversations with people.
Yeah, absolutely. So and so you say you've got some online courses that you put together?
Yeah, so I'm just about to launch the first course. I've got a coaching program that's already launched, but the online course is for up and coming entrepreneurs that really just want to get a grasp of sales. You may, never have done a sales call, or you have done them and hated them so much you're scared to do them again. And this is just simply called the Sales Success System. So it's an online course that's going to give you everything you need to understand the process of just having amazing, natural conversations with your ideal clients. Really understanding that actually, as long if you have a good conversation and ask the right questions, you'll never have to sell again. Not in the way that you think.
Well, yeah, exactly. And now, like you're working on your course, and part of that, I think you said by the time this show is launched, it actually will be live. Because right now I'm also working on a book, and it's called, or the working title right now is The Winner's Code. And then the subtitle is Secrets of the Winner's Mindset. And if you're coming from, to me, a sales conversation is, if you're coming from the right mindset, let's say I call it the winner's mindset, which is a win-win, win-win concept. If you're coming from that, and there's somebody that's interested, they're already saying that they may be interested in buying your product. Otherwise, they wouldn't even be having the conversation with you. So,
exactly. So 90% of a sale is done through mindset. 90% of a successful business is down to your mindset.
Yes.
Let's not undermine whether you like using the word mindset. I do. I think it's a very powerful word and it says what it does. But I know some people like to talk about attitudes and things like that, which is fine. It's the same thing.
Yeah.
But if you are 100% confident in what you do as a business owner, whether it be a coach, a consultant, a service provider, whatever you do, as long as you are 100% confident that what you do and what you provide and the results that you get for your ideal clients is what they need, that's your biggest barrier to selling. Yes. So many, because it's a transfer of energy. And if you're not 100% certain that what you have is right for the prospect that you're talking to, that energy is going to come across. You're going to start moving away from the sale because you're going to start questioning whether it's a good thing. Confidence is the number one key. How often have you had conversations with that car salesman, or you've been in a shop to buy a TV, or even had a conversation with somebody on the phone, and they might have an amazing product that is absolutely perfect for you, but they've sounded nervous, or they've stuttered over their words, or they don't sound convinced themselves what they're saying is the right thing. Confidence in what you do and what your client needs to achieve is absolutely key.
Yes,
because they're going to buy. They are, people do buy from people. They're going to grasp that confidence that you have, and that's going to help you move them forward into the right buying decision. I used to do some workshops, and the workshops were called Stop Selling and Help Clients Buy. Now it's called Stop Selling, Start Serving, because we go through different iterations as your business grows. But helping clients buy is exactly what you're doing. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, that reverse psychology, nobody likes being told what they think or what they feel. So one of the biggest parts of the sales success system is all about questions. Questions are the answers. The more questions you ask your prospects, the more you will be seen as an expert. So actually, the less talking you do, the more you'll sell, if you look at it that way.
And I was about to say that, just shut up. So you answer the question, you just be quiet, because sometimes the first person that talks, I don't want to say this is the loser, the person that does that may not have control over that conversation.
Yeah. Well, one of the tricks that I talk about in the program, one of the tips that you get is to write WAIT, W-A-I-T, with dots in between, because it's an acronym. Have it on a sticky note on your screen if need be. Why am I talking? Right? Okay. Because if you are talking, you're not selling. That is the key. Because what you want is somebody else to realize by the questions that you're asking that what you have, what the product or service that you have is right for them.
Yeah, well, and I agree with that because you can very easily talk yourself out of a sale if you're going into the, and I'm doing finger quotes here, convincing conversation, then you're most likely are dissuading that client from you.
Yeah, if you go into a convincing mode, and very often people go into convincing mode at the end of a conversation because they don't know when to shut up. Because they ask for the sale and they afraid of silence, so they just keep talking, or they're not quite sure when to ask for the sale, so they just keep talking. So either way, you end up in this loop of one of the worst things you can say at the end of a conversation is, "Do you have any questions?" Rather than, "Would you like to start?"
Yes, you just ask, exactly.
People ask, "Do you have any questions?" at the end because they're scared to say, "Do you want to buy? Are you ready to start? Are you ready to sign? You know, shall we get you started?" Whatever in the process, the next steps are.
That could be cash or credit. So.
Yeah. We take credit cards, MasterCards, whatever it might be. How do you want to pay? Yeah. As long as I have a close off point in a conversation. Once I've told somebody about what we do and how we do it and how it can benefit them, there are two very simple questions. Can you commit to this? And do you want to do it? Yeah, they need to be able to commit to, I'm a coach, so my services, it involves them being present and showing up and doing the work. So it's not a service. So are you committed to do this? Can you do, can you commit the time and the energy to do this? Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Okay, do you want to do this? Absolutely. Right, let's talk about next steps. Then we talk about the investment piece then. We don't talk about it before, because if you talk about it before, they'll tell you that the time's not right. Or that they're not committed. So you get the commitment, you get them to tell you that they want to work with you, and then we talk about the investment piece, and then we shut up.
And I'm so glad you just said that, because she said the word twice. She said the word investment. She didn't say how much. That this is how much you have to pay, or this is what it's going to cost you. She's basically saying, how much do you want to invest in solving whatever problem that you're going to be solving? So it is exactly that. So for those of you that are coaches, or that are going to be doing some kind of service-based business, then yeah, it would be a kind of investment. Now, of course, if you're, let me ask you this: if you owned a restaurant and let's say Sue came into the restaurant and I served you the food and stuff like that, you are expecting to pay at the end. Now, mm-hmm. if the person is coming to you to hear what you have to say, they know there's going to be a sale at some point. Because you have to look at it from the perspective of the client as well. The client is going to be they know a sale's coming. Otherwise, they're not going to be there to begin with. You don't go into a car lot to say, "I don't want to buy a car. I don't want to spend any money." No, you're already in the pre-sale mode.
Exactly. You already have enough. And if you've done your marketing strategy right, you are only talking to people that are ready to buy. Mm-hmm. And the only reason that you wouldn't is that at some point during that conversation, you realize that there's a misalignment somewhere. Mm-hmm. Somebody might be thinking that you do something that you don't do, but you find all of this out early on. You find out that somebody actually isn't ready. They don't have the prerequisite, for example. They've never coached in, for me, I work with a lot of coaches and they might say, "I want to start a coaching business, but I haven't trained to be a coach yet." Well, you need to go away and train to be a coach first, right? So there are going to be times in the conversation where you will qualify somebody out because for whatever reason that it's not a good match.
Oh yeah, and you don't want to, number one, take their money just for being the authentic side, and number two, most likely they're not going to get the results that they're hiring you for, and that's just going to leave a bad taste in their mouth and could leave bad reviews for you. So I mean, why?
Well, absolutely, and to be fair, during the conversation, you will end up in convincing mode because you're going to try and convince them that they are ready. Mm-hmm. And I've heard it and seen it happen time and time again. And what happens is those people are less committed from day one. In fact, they're probably the most likely to get a refund before you even start because they'll go away. And because you convince them to buy something, they feel like they've been done by. Right. Whereas what the idea of, the sales success system, it's about reverse psychology. It's about people talking themselves into a sale, because when you talk yourself into something, that decision is solid. So yes. When you ask questions, what would happen if you didn't move forward? How important is this to you? Why have you not been able to do this on your own? You're not saying, well, you haven't been able to do this on your own before, you need my help. You're asking the questions. When somebody says, I always go away and think about things, do you think that might be a reason why you've continued to go around in circles? Do you think your lack of action might come from the fact that you're not decisive and you don't take action? You're not telling them, you're asking them a question. They may not answer, but they're inside, they'll know the answer.
Because one of the biggest questions I often hear, or maybe even use myself, is where else is this showing up in your life? Where else is this lack of decision making? I mean, let's say, for an example, we're talking about Bitcoin, you know, whatever. Let's say I was a Bitcoin guy, and I was going to show you how to do a Bitcoin. And I got asked that question, does this show up in your relationships? When you're in the pub, or in the bar, as we call it, if you're in the pub and you want to go talk to that pretty girl, but you don't go talk to her because you got to think about it. Like, where else are these hesitations holding you back?
So. Yeah. And like you said, you're just asking the question. So people are subconsciously coming to a decision that this is the right thing and they need to do it now. So when they do make the decision, it's a very solid decision.
Right.
It's not a flimsy decision. It's not one that they feel like they've had their arm twisted into. So you're reducing the chance of somebody going away and regretting that decision, because that does happen. You know, and we talk about, well, I call it buttoning down. We talk about buttoning down and making sure people are really solid before you get them off the phone. The last thing you do when you, whether it's face-to-face or on the phone, is go, oh, brilliant, you've signed up, you've paid your money, fantastic. Okay, well, I'll send you all the information you'll need. I'll see you later. Bye. You know, actually, that's when you've got to really spend time with somebody and really get them, you know, really celebrate the decision that they've just made.
I've been seeing that a lot, because I've seen both sides. I mean, I bought things and sometimes feel like, okay, now that they just processed the payment, okay, next. And I get that. Because let's say if somebody buys my book, for an example, you know, we're not going to be having a 20-minute conversation in a room of 100 people. I mean, that's just...
If somebody's just invested $5,000, $6,000, $7,000 in you know, in their mindset or their business or their sales skills or, you know, or even a weight loss program, then that's a big decision. And, you know, to walk away from somebody and dismiss that, that's going to leave them feeling a little bit pained, because they're like, oh my gosh, I've just paid 5,000. Whereas you spend a little bit of time with that person, congratulating them, getting them to think about the decision they've just made, getting them to start picturing themselves in 4 months, 6 months time. I tell people to go away and however they like to celebrate, whether they have a drink or whether they a cup of coffee or go and eat chocolate or go for a run. However you want to celebrate, you need to go and celebrate right now, because you've just made an amazing decision. Go and put a red ring around your calendar, because today was the day that you chose to change your life. So get people really excited about the decision that they've just made. Because, you know, the sales process is not about tricks. It's not about, you know, how do I convince somebody of something? You don't need to convince anybody. You just need to have amazing conversations.
And I fully agree with you. That's what I'm coming up with when I'm writing the winner's code. Is exactly that. Is you have to make it a win-win for both parties. And it's not a win-win where you are faking it or pretending or trying to get over on somebody. It's a true win-win. They've invested in you, which is a win for yourself, because now you've got some money and other income coming in. And then it's a win for them, because it's, you know, it is a true remarkable change that they're implementing. As you said, it could be a weight loss program, it could be a lifestyle change, it could be whatever it is that you're offering.
When you have the conversations like I have, and when you have the conversations and go through the sales success system, what happens is, even if for some reason somebody doesn't move forward, timing issue, financial issue, whatever it might be, you come off knowing that you've just had an amazing conversation and that you have made some impact. When they do start working with you, when they do sign up and, you know, take those next steps, yes, you've made a sale. Yes, you've created income for your business. But when you come off the phone excited about your client's future for them, you can't wait to start working with them. You can't wait for them to start getting the results, because you know what you have is going to change their life, their business. That's when you know that you've had a true, authentic connection and conversation with somebody, and that you haven't just gone through the sales process and you just come off and think, oh, thank goodness for that. You know, I can pay my bills this month. If you come off the phone like that, then you've just done a sales process.
And that could be very easily read as a desperation ploy, or something that's also not authentic.
Yeah. And I think, you know, you and I were speaking, you know, just before we came live today about, you know, pricing and how to price and your services. And actually, you know, the prerequisite to being able to have these amazing conversations is to really understand your worth in the first place. And also be able to charge your services, charge for your results, price the program that you deliver, the service that you deliver, at a level that enables people to see real value. You'll be surprised, or you may not be surprised, Kevin, you probably aren't, but you know, I'm sure some people are surprised, because they are when I tell them this, that when you raise your prices, that's when you start getting more clients, because people start to see you seriously.
Right, because I had a lady that was early on in this season, like in the single digit episodes, and one of the things that she did is that she quoted her price to a potential client, and the person refused to do business with her because she was too cheap.
Yeah.
They didn't think they would get value out of that. The first person she went to, she charged X number of dollars, and she said she was too expensive. She raised her price, and the other person said she was too cheap. So you can never know by the market, but you can definitely do your testing. And a mentor of mine, maybe, I don't know if you would agree with this or not, she basically said that once 5 people are willing to pay your price for your services, it's time to raise your price.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you've got to be sensible with it, but you're absolutely right. At some point, and the value that you give will actually go up the more that you do what you do. You know, the more testimonials you have, the more, I mean, I know when I was working with another coach before, yes, the program was exactly the same as it was 2 years ago, but the amount of extras and bonus material and experience that she'd gained over the years to enable people to get results quicker, you know, justified the increase in pricing as that program became more successful. Mm-hmm. So don't think that your pricing has to be set in stone, but whatever you do, don't underprice.
It doesn't be a hard thing to judge, because I would say most of the people that I've interviewed on the show that we talked about pricings, they always started too low.
It's hard to go up if you start too low, because if you go too low, you're attracting the wrong audience.
Exactly.
So you're working with the wrong people. So really understanding your worth and your value, and understanding your target market. You know, I spoke to you before about the guide that I do about doubling your rates. It's all about understanding that actually you need to really understand and narrow down your market. Because if you're trying to serve everybody, you end up serving nobody. You know, it's the same in marketing. But also, if you're seen as a jack of all trades, people are going to pay you a generalist fee. Whereas, do you use jack of all trades in the States? Yes, sometimes yes, I say yes, things. Yes. But it's like, do you want to pay a generalist price, or do you want to pay a specialist price? If you are a specialist, then it's not about having specialist training. It's not necessarily about knowing something that others don't do. That's not what a specialist is about. A specialist is about somebody that really works in one market. So therefore, their product or service is defined to that market. So let me give you an example. If you think about like a physiotherapist or a physical therapist, I think you call them. Yeah, you know, they go to university, they go to medical school, they have lots and lots of training. And if you go and see somebody, if you come and see somebody in the UK, and if you happen to go private, not the NHS where you get it free, but if you happen to go private, you'll pay about £35 to £50 an hour. Maybe, you know, in the States, maybe $50 to $75 an hour to go and see that physical therapist. And they'll work with you on your back, your arms, your shoulders, after surgery, if you've had an injury, arthritis, but they'll be able to help you in any area. But if that same physiotherapist who has had exactly the same training then decides, actually, I'm going to focus on knees. I'm going to be a knee specialist. Not only am I going to be a knee specialist, but I'm going to be a knee specialist for professional footballers or soccer players. All of a sudden, they can charge £2,000 an hour for their services because they are focusing on one area, which means that they can really, you know, invest in specialist equipment, make sure that they're only working with the right people. And all of a sudden, they're seen as the go-to person. And once one or two footballers have gone to them, everybody will go to them. Right?
That's absolutely true. Because, yes, if you specialize, that's who you are known for. And I'm going to go a little bit beyond the scope of the show, and we're actually running out of time here. One of the things, because I'm also a real estate agent here in the U.S. I know you guys call them estate agents.
Estate agents, yeah. I always get tongue-tied on real estate as well. I think not the real estate word, the realtor.
Realtor. Yeah, most of us call it realtor. There's no second A. It's realtor. The realtor, because I've also been in real estate myself as a realtor, and I specialized when I first got started. Yes, I can help you buy your house. I can help you sell your house. I can help you rent your house. But my specialty was what is known as a lease option or rent to own or some form of some kind of owner financing or seller financing. So people that come to me are the ones that want to buy a house, but they can't buy a house because they don't have the credit in order to get a loan, or they have a bankruptcy or whatever. So I became the specialist in that area of real estate. Now, yes, I can still do the other stuff, like the knee guy can also do shoulders and elbows, but you know, I could still do that if there was a call for it. But you know, that became my specialty. That was my focus. I became so well known in that industry that other agents would refer me clients because they didn't really know how to do that process.
Exactly, because you do gain more experience the more you do one thing. Mm-hmm. And you know, I don't know how vets cope, because they don't even, the amount of the anatomy that a vet has to learn is unbelievable. I think you should specialize as a vet. But but in the coaching and the service industry, if you narrow down your services, what happens, two things happen, is one, people will get better results because everything that you do is tailored for them. It's not too general. So if you've got particular coaching methods or a particular coaching system, you can really tailor it to that particular person. So for example, if you're working in weight loss for women over the age of 40 that are premenopausal, you can make sure, you can talk about that in all of your coaching modules, and you can give them supplements that help with the menopause, and you can give them mindset work, because everything has mindset in it. I don't care what type of coaching it is. So the mindset piece can be all about age and, you know, maybe not being able to get into your pre-baby clothes, whatever it might be. Whereas if you were just in a general weight loss, everything would have to be generic. You wouldn't be able to go that deep in the training that you do. So therefore, the results that people get are actually less. So, you know, more people are going to get better results, which again enables you to charge higher rates. When you charge higher rates, people are more invested in working with you and making the results happen. They're not going to give up. They're not going to waste the investment. So it's actually a win-win-win situation when you increase your rates. You attract the right people. You get better results for those people. And those people are far more committed. Or you can carry on charging $50 an hour and really not know exactly who you want to work with and make life difficult for yourself. So,
and that's, I'm very glad that you were saying that, because yes, I mean, even I'm even looking at myself as like, who is my ideal client and how can I narrow that down even further? Or like you were saying, maybe the woman that may be in premenopause, and then you may be dealing with postmenopause as well as a secondary ideal client. You may not be combining them in the same marketing campaign or the same
training. Exactly.
But you can serve other people. So like the knee doctor could be an elbow doctor and could be a shoulder doctor, you know, whatever, but he can, you know, for the football players or we call them soccer players, the knees and ankles are probably gonna be the most important because you're always running. You're not doing much with your arms. But now if you also want to do with people that play rugby, now you've got that other specialty as well. So you can have more than one specialy.
Yeah, it's just all about, it's that marketing message. The marketing, I mean, we're probably going a little bit pre-sales, but this is really important because you can't have an authentic connection and dig deep into somebody's pain and give them the reason why you add so much value if you're talking to at a very general level. You know, so you've got to do the pre-work to make sure that you really know who you're serving. And that marketing message is then key. You know, as well as I do, when you're online these days, you have milliseconds to get somebody's attention. Mm-hmm. You know, so you can't just put an ad out there with a menu of services, you know, your arms, your legs, your back, your knees, whatever, you know, have you had an injury? Do you have arthritis? Because nobody's going to recognize that. But if the headline is, do you have a football injury? You know, or do you have a knee injury from football? Anybody that's had a knee injury from football is going to stop scrolling right there and then. So yes, everybody else will scroll past. And I think that's the mindset shift that a lot of people have to go through, is they fear that because they can help everybody, they shouldn't close the door to people. But you need to close the door to people. Otherwise, nobody's going to come through the door, because nobody's going to value what you have. And that's going to enable you then to go through, like the sales success system, you can go through a very authentic conversation, because you're not trying to wing it. You're not trying to figure out, because you probably can help everybody you talk to, but the sales conversation needs to have complete confidence. You know, you've had a sports injury. Well, when I worked with Jeff with his sports injury, this is what we did. We went through this, we went through that, we went through the other. I'm going to have you back on the pitch in 6 weeks. How does that sound?
Okay. Well,
yeah, you know, people are going to go, perfect, let's do it, because you have that confidence and you can talk about it with such clarity. And I like to use analogies like that, because most people can relate to them. So it really doesn't matter whether you sell websites, whether you're a coach, whether you sell some kind of other service. You know, even if you're an accountant or a lawyer, it's exactly the same thing. It's just having that confidence to really care about the person that you're talking to.
Yeah, it had the confidence and the care for the client.
Yeah.
Like you said, it doesn't matter if you're an attorney or a massage therapist or, you know, whatever it is, people are coming to you for a reason. As long as you show them that you do care authentically and have the confidence that you have the ability. I mean, the last thing you want to do is have an attorney you guys call them barristers, having an attorney or barrister that's very shy and they won't stand up. Like, do you want him in your court? If you had to go to court, would you want him to be there for you, representing you? Well, we are basically out of time. If somebody wanted to be able to get your sales success system or want to hire you for your coaching services, how can they find you?
Well, you can go to the website, first of all. Everything is on there, SueRichardsCoaching.com. I do have a Facebook group as well, which is more of a community. And you can just go in. Yeah, I don't know if you'll put the link in there, Kevin, but if not, if you just search the Coaches Success Club, it's like I say, it's not just for coaches. It's all about people that are, you know, just have any kind of service, because we're all an expert in our field, which is why I use the word coaches. The Coaches Success Club, in there is where I share lots more information about, you know, sales and the sales process, but we also, you know, share and collaborate on how to grow our businesses. So we have technical experts, marketing experts, copywriting experts all in there as well. So people are welcome to come and join the club there. And there you'll get a lot of information about the sales success system and also my free guide to how you can double your rates with confidence and charge your value.
Okay, so her website again is Sue, S-U-E, Richards, R-I-C-H-A-R-D-S, coaching, C-O-A-C-H-I-N-G.com. And you can also find her on Facebook by searching the Coaches Success Club. And then the URL will be down below in the description for both your website as well as for the Facebook group. And I know that's how we met, that's how we started talking, was because of your Facebook group, because you were providing value. I was starting to, because I just joined, because I was expanding my business, so I was providing value there. And just to let you guys know, it doesn't matter where in the world that you are. I mean, I'm deliberately doing interviews from people not in the United States right now, because I just want to show that the world is interconnected.
I mean, the world is getting smaller.
Yes. Yes, it is. And I mean, because I've had people on the show from Australia, from Russia, from the UK, like you are now. I just recently had a lady from Spain, and some people in South America. I have a gentleman from Johannesburg coming on. So it's just showing just how interconnected we are. And on her Facebook group or Facebook page, I guess it is a group. It doesn't matter where you are. I mean, we all have very similar challenges. So it doesn't matter the language you speak or what have you.
Exactly. Yeah, it's universal. Just come and join, and you know, you can add value as much as you can take value as well, which is what I love about the group. You know, we're a group of collaborators, really, a community. Mm-hmm.
Yes, yes. And give value, or at least see what's out there and learn from other people's questions or mistakes or challenges.
So, exactly, yeah.
Okay. So again, that's, you can find her online at SueRichardsCoaching.com, and she does do coaching as well, sales coaching as well. My name is Kevin Dunlap. I do actually business coaching, and my main thing is helping men and women, mainly women, it appears, make the transition from corporate America to become an entrepreneur. So that's a mindset shift. That's why I'm writing the book. And then people like Sue here can help you double your revenue, or at least start getting revenue in your new business while you're making that transition from the corporation to your own business.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay. Well, I want to say that, Sue, thank you for being on the show today. Any last words for our audience before we say goodbye to everybody?
Just have confidence. It's my number one rule. Have complete confidence in everything that you do, and people will feed off that, and they will want to work with you because of that.
So just have confidence. That's a very good thing. Because yes, and that may take some time to have confidence if you're just starting out, because your system may be unproven. But at least if you know that you start seeing people make changes in their lives, it doesn't matter if you're providing a service or a product. When you see people start making change in their lives for the better, that will just reinforce your ability to have.
Yeah, it's micro steps. You know, you can be confident without feeling confident. And that's a whole nother podcast.
Yeah. We have to have you come back on the show here in a couple of months and see how things are going with you. Well, everybody, again, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Leave a comment below. Let us know how you thought of the show. Let us know what you thought of Sue or even myself. And I think you gave us some very, very valuable information. We ran almost 40 minutes now, 42
wow.
minutes.
Wow.
On a 30-minute show. So we went a little long, but that's perfectly okay. And well, I do want to say, everybody, thank you for tuning in. And again, subscribe to our show so you can hear some more incredible people. And Sue, again, thank you for being on the show.
Thank you.
Okay. All right, goodbye, everybody.
Thanks so much for listening to this episode of Life's Little Lessons with your host, author of Designing Your Own Destiny, Kevin A. Dunlap. For more great content and to stay up to date, visit KevinADunlap.com, Facebook.com/KevinADunlap.author, and on Twitter @KevinADunlap. We'll catch you on the next episode of Life's Little Lessons.